Good morning students, welcome to the network security lab class for 6th semester IT students. So today we'll be discuss about virus, how virus infect the computer, types of virus, how to protect the computer from your virus, and what is the difference between malware and your virus. So let's start with what is virus and how it's affect to our system. So first is your what is virus. The virus full form is vital information under cyst. As basic knowledge, virus is one type of software that harmful for our system. Okay, so it is a malicious software program loaded onto a user computer without the user knowledge and perform malicious actions. Okay, so next is how does a computer get a virus. There are many ways a computer can become infected with a computer virus or other malwares. When a virus is made, it's often distributed through your shareware, pirated software, email, point-to-point programs or other programs where users share the data. Once downloaded, copied or otherwise acquired, if the infected program is executed, it can potentially affect anything that a computer can access. So from this point, we got what is the meaning of virus and how does a computer get a virus. What can a virus do to a computer? It deletes some or all files without the consent. It causes various error messages in files or on programs. It changes volume label. It marks clusters as bad in the FAT. FAT is nothing but called file allocation table. Okay? It create more than one partition. It causes cross-linked files. It causes a sector not found error. It decreases the speed of computer, causing the system to run slow or be low on resources. It create logical partitions or partitions decrease in size. Means if virus is affected, your partition size is automatically decrease. Make directories appear as garbage. Means some directories display as garbage. Okay. Now, next is your, it causes hardware problems such as keyboard keys are not working, printer is display some error message, that is called printer issues arise, modem issues are arise, disable ports such as LPT or COM port. Means it automatically, if your virus is affected, it automatically disable the LPT port and COM port, means your printer port and communication port also. Okay. It causes keyboard keys to be remapped. Remapped means what? Whenever you are pressing the A key, it automatically display Z. If you are pressing B key, it display Q, like such a manner. So if it is display like such a manner, then you think that your system is getting affected with your virus. Alter the system date and time. Means my CMOS battery is okay, but automatically my date and time is going on changing. That means we think that we are affected with your virus. Next, it causes system to hang or freeze randomly. Okay. It causes activity on hard disks or floppy disks randomly. Increase the file size. It change the file attributes. Okay, now see, increase file size means suppose one file size is 10 MB,
automatically display that it is 15 MB. Okay, and change the file attributes means what? Suppose one file is attributes is your read-only file or archive file, automatically the attribute is getting changes. Okay, then it increase or decrease memory size. It randomly change file or memory size. It extend boot times. It cause a computer to make strange noise, make music, clicking noises or beeps. It display pictures randomly. Unusual or undocumented error message should be displayed. So be careful about all these things, because if your system is affected with your virus, these types of symptoms should be performed on your systems. Okay. Next is your types of virus. Means what are the different types of viruses are present? So first one is your boot sector virus. It is a type of virus that infect the boot sector of floppy disk or the master boot record, which is also called as MBR of hard disk. The boot sector comprises all files which are required to start the operating system of the computer. The virus either overwrites the existing program or copies itself to another part of the disk. That means if you are having boot sector virus, means your system is getting affected with boot sector virus, then it affects the boot sector area of your disk, that may be your hard disk, or if it is bootable disk, that is your floppy disk or CD also. Okay, now it disturbs your boot sector or the master boot record MBR of your hard disk. Direct action virus. When a virus attaches itself directly to a .exe or .com file and enter the device while its execution, is called direct action virus. It directly affect to the .exe and .com files. Okay, so if it gets installed in the memory, it keeps itself hidden. It is also known as non-resident virus. Okay, now next is your resident virus. A virus which saves itself in the memory of the computer and then infects other files and programs when its originating program is no longer working. Okay, this virus can easily infect other files because it is hidden in the memory. That means it is not visible, it is totally hidden and residing where? Residing in your memory. Okay, and it is hard to the remove from the system because it is not visible. That's why it is difficult to remove the virus file from the disk. And next is your multipartite virus. A virus which can attack both the boot sector and the executable files of an already infected computer is called a multipartite virus. If a multipartite virus attacks your system, you are at risk of cyber threats. Okay, so whatever the cyber threats are there, that is inside this multipartite virus. Then override virus, that completely remove the existing program and replace it with a malicious code by overwriting it. Gradually, it can completely replace the host program code with a harmful code. Okay, means whatever the code is written by you, if this override virus program is inside your disk, then it automatically changes with a new type of coding, okay, which will disturb your total program code. Next, polymorphic virus. It spread through spam and infected websites, and these virus are file infectors which are complex and are tough to detect. It means it is not easily find out. they create a modified or morphed version of the existing program and infect the system and retain the original code. Then next one is your file infected virus. As the name suggests, it first infects a single file and then later spread itself to other executable files and programs. The main source of this virus are games and word processor. Okay, so first it affects the single, then later on it is going on spreading one by one files. Next is your space filler virus. It is a rare type of virus which fills in the empty spaces of a file with virus. Means those files is having some empty space. On that empty space, these viruses fill up. It is known as cavity virus. It will neither affect the size of the file nor can be detected easily. Then, macro virus. It's a virus written in the same macro language as used in the software program and infect the computer if a word processor file is opened. Mainly the source of such virus is via email. So through email it should be affected. Then how to protect your computer from your virus? Okay, so here the point arises, how we should protect our system from the virus. The most suitable way of making your computer virus free is by installing one type of antivirus. Okay, so antivirus is one type of software that should clean the virus. So from up to this point we know virus is one type of software. It harms your system, it disturbs your system, it affects your system. But antivirus is one type of software that clean the virus from your system. Okay, so if antivirus software is there, it protect your system from the virus. Such software helps in removing the virus from the device and can be installed in a computer via two means. Means your antivirus software should be installed in two way. Means you are able to purchase, that is called buying an antivirus software and install it. You should purchase it, otherwise from the online download also. But be remember, if you are purchasing the original software, antivirus software, that is good for your system. And for the online download, it is having some limited of period is there. Okay, so on online download you are able to collect the antivirus software, or by purchasing the antivirus software you can install it on your system. Now next is difference between, what is the difference between malware and the virus? Now the question arises, we heard about the virus word, but we also heard about the malware word also. So now question arises on your mind, we think that virus and malware, both the things are same. Okay, but here we should justify it whether these two things are same or not. Malware and virus are mostly considered to be the same thing, and people generally tend to interchange their meaning. Thus, it is important for one to know the difference between malware and the virus, as these two terms are technically different from totally each other. Okay. So malware is a type of malicious software which intends to infect the host computer, whereas virus is a type of malware software itself. It infects file and then spread through a device whenever the file or program is run. Okay, so now see the difference. Malware means what? Here also told you, malware is one type of malicious software which intend to infect the host computer. Okay, so it infect the host computer, whereas virus is one type of malware software which itself infect the files and spread through a device whenever the file or program is run. Now see the difference between malware and virus. What is malware? A software that is specifically designed to disturb, damage or gain unauthorized access to a computer system. Whereas, virus means what? A piece of code which is capable of copying itself and typically has a detrimental effect, such as corrupting the system or destroying the data. Okay, so here you got the idea about virus, types of virus, how the virus is affect to the computer, and how we should protect it, and what is the difference between your malware and your virus. So in the next class we'll be discuss with more of things about the next topic.